The U.S. Navy's newest Virginia-class attack submarine, the future USS Oregon, SSN-793, has been christened in Connecticut on the 5th of October. The submarine was ordered on the 28th of April 2014, and its keel was laid down on the 8th of July 2017. The christening was done in a ceremony held at the Quonset Point facility of General Dynamics Electric Boat in North Kingstown, Rhode Island. Mrs. Dana L. Richardson, wife of the Chief of Naval Operations, Admiral John Richardson, was the sponsor. Vice Admiral James Kilby said Oregon, outfitted with the most modern weapons and sensors, will disappear beneath the waves and never be detected until a time and place of its choosing. Kilby added, it truly represents naval combat power. In this video, Defense Updates reports on the latest Block 4 Virginia-class submarine, USS Oregon. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. The Virginia class, sometimes referred to as SSN-774 class, is a class of nuclear-powered, fast-attack submarines in service with the United States Navy. Virginia class is designed to replace older Los Angeles class submarines, many of which have already been decommissioned. Virginia class submarines will be acquired through 2043 and are expected to remain in service till 2070. Virginia-class submarines are designed for a broad spectrum of open ocean and littoral missions. Their primary purpose is to take out enemy surface combatants and submarines, and the secondary task is to execute land attack missions. Virginia-class submarines were the first U.S. Navy warships designed with the help of computer-aided design, CAD, and visualization technology, CATIA. Each submarine is projected to make 14 to 15 deployments during its 33-year service life. The Virginia class was intended in part as a less expensive alternative to the Seawolf class submarines, $1.8 billion versus $2.8 billion, whose production run was stopped after just 3 boats had been completed. To reduce costs, the Virginia class submarines use many commercial off-the-shelf COTS components, especially in their computers and data networks. In practice, they actually cost less than $1.8 billion in the fiscal year 2009 dollars each due to improvements in shipbuilding technology. The Virginia class is built through an industrial arrangement designed to maintain both GD Electric Boat and Newport News Shipbuilding, the only two U.S. shipyards capable of building nuclear-powered submarines. Under the present arrangement, the Newport News facility builds the stern, habitability, machinery spaces, torpedo room, sail, and bow, while Electric Boat builds the engine room and control room. The facilities alternate work on the reactor plant, as well as the final assembly, test, outfit, and delivery. USS Oregon has been built by shipbuilder General Dynamics Electric Boat in Groton. It has a length of 115 meters. To give viewers a perspective, its length is slightly greater than that of a football field. It displaces about 7,900 tons. USS Oregon, like all other Block 4 subs, is acknowledged to be able to move to depths of 240 meters, that's 800 feet, but allegedly capable of going down to 490 meters, that's 1,600 feet. A single S9G reactor that produces around 30 megawatts powers Oregon. The reactor features improved corrosion resistance and reduced life cycle costs. It also has reduced size and weight, enabling the submarine to pack more weapons and sensors. The S9G reactor is designed to operate for 33 years without refueling. So, USS Oregon has a practically unlimited range, limited by only food supplies and maintenance requirements. The reactor produces enough power to propel Oregon over 25 knots, that's 46 kilometers per hour or 29 miles per hour, though the actual numbers may be significantly higher. Block 4 consists of 10 submarines. On April 28, 2014, the most costly shipbuilding contract in history was awarded to General Dynamics Electric Boat as the prime contractor. The deal for 10 Block 4 Virginia-class attack submarines was worth $17.6 billion. The main improvement over the Block 3 is the reduction of major maintenance periods from 4 to 3, increasing each ship's total lifetime deployments by 1. So, the Block 4 variant will be capable of a total of about 15 deployments. The Virginia class is the first to use photonic sensors instead of traditional periscope. The class is equipped with high-resolution cameras, along with light intensification and infrared sensors, as well as an infrared laser rangefinder. Block 4 variant of Virginia class has redesigned elements and features several types of sonar arrays. 1. It incorporates a large aperture bow, lab, water-backed array, which replaces the traditional air-backed spherical array. This, the main sonar, is one of the most powerful sonars mounted in any of the submarines in the world. 2. Two high-frequency active sonars mounted in the sail and bow. These supplement the main sonar array, improving anti-submarine warfare performance. 3. A fiber optic sonar array, consisting of 3 flat panels, is present on either side of the hull. 4. For coverage above and behind the submarine, a high-frequency sonar is mounted on both sides of the submarine sail. USS Oregon is also equipped with a low-frequency towed sonar array and a high-frequency towed sonar array. USS Oregon will be deadly, as it's packed with different kinds of weapons to knock out varied targets. 1. Two large diameter Virginia payload tubes, each capable of launching 6 Tomahawk cruise missiles. Tomahawk is a long-range, all-weather cruise missile that's used for land-based attacks. It has a long range of 1,200 to 2,500 kilometers, enabling them to be launched from far off. 2. 4 533mm torpedo tubes for the Mark 48 torpedo. There's a capacity to carry up to 26 Mark 48 torpedoes in the weapons chamber. These torpedoes have a range in excess of 50 kilometers or 31 miles and can be used to take out enemy submarines and surface vessels. 3. Like all Virginia class, Oregon can also lay different types of mines, including the Mark 60 Captor encapsulated torpedo mines. 4. An integral lockout, lock-in chamber is incorporated into the hull for special operations. The chamber can host a mini submarine, such as Northrop Grumman's Advanced SEALs delivery system, that can be used to transport special warfare forces, such as Navy SEAL teams. The main rivals of the US, Russia and China, are going ahead with the construction of several new subs. Russia plans to build a total of 8 Yas and M-class submarines, which are intended to destroy US aircraft carriers. The latest Kilo-class submarine of the Russian fleet is also a force to take note of. Though Kilo-class is nothing new and has been around in some form or another since the 1980s, the newest 6 submarines of this class represent a significant evolution. Russia is also building the Boreai class, which will be Russia's new generation of ballistic missile submarines, the cornerstone and most survivable part of its nuclear arsenal. The Chinese Navy has been given special attention and is getting a good share of the military budget. It's developing a wide range of conventional as well as nuclear-powered submarines. The Virginia-class Block 4 submarines are multi-mission vessels as they're equipped with torpedoes to take out enemy subs and surface ships, and missiles for land attack, as well as can perform a variety of tasks like surveillance work and the delivery of special operations forces. Hence, USS Oregon will be an excellent addition to the US Navy fleet.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.